thank you for joining us this episode of the Drawn Out Podcast.
How's it going, kids? It's been a while. It's been like a week.
Yeah.
How was school? Good.
We assume good. That's all
did,
you
did
do.
Did you finally talk to her, huh?
Did she say no?
Oh.
Oh, she pulled down your pants in front of the school.
Oh.
They were just
it's all right, though. You're a monster dog. Oh, yeah.
I'm Raimi.
I'm Shannon.
This is Brandon.
That is Brandon.
Blake.
I'm Kyle.
Hey, Kyle.
Hi.
Introduce yourself. You're new to this.
I am a guest today.
It's true. He has his own podcast.
I don't know why he's not doing his own, but, you know.
But this episode, we're going to be talking about Doctor Strange, the newest Marvel movie
in the MCU.
Good. First impressions, I fucking loved it.
It's true. Didn't you say that it replaced Winter Soldier for your favorite?
It did. It's my number one.
Really?
Yes, sir. I saw it twice.
You liked Winter Soldier more than Civil War?
Hmm?
Okay.
Can we call it?
I respect your wrong opinion.
Can we call it a war, though? I mean, it seemed like more of a civil dispute.
It was a skirmish.
It was a civil war.
Real quick, though, we're going to get into spoilers in a second, but I just want everyone to say just a sentence of what they thought of it, spoiler-free.
Pretty fucking dope.
Blake?
I loved it, but I felt like it wasn't a movie that I'd watch over and over again.
Oh, yeah?
That's kind of fair. I mean,
you can't say that. You saw it multiple times.
Exactly.
Already.
And that's why I'm saying that is because the second time around wasn't as good, but I think part of that's due to the fact that it wasn't in IMAX.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I think with Marvel movies,
it has to be in 3D and IMAX. And
with this one,
I saw it in 2D, and I was all right with it.
Wasn't bad in 2D, it was just not as good.
I feel like it would have been a better response had I seen it in 2D first and then 3D, but I mean, I can't complain with the fucking amazing showing we got to see.
Well, we saw it in the museum like fucking badasses.
Oh, yeah, huge screen.
I'll look it up so everyone can understand.
Biggest screen.
Yes. It is a huge screen.
It is very large. This screen is jumbo dick.
I cannot.
Are we still talking about a screen?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Maybe.
It's six stories high. I remember that.
Wait, what?
The museum?
Yeah. I would say it feels a lot like Ant-Man to me.
Ant-Man.
That's a good comparison.
If you like Ant-Man, I think you'll like this in the exact same way.
Yeah. I guess my impression was, just like Ant-Man, it's a character I didn't really know a lot about. I've seen a little bit about, but surprisingly liked the movie more than I thought I would.
There was way more kung fu than I thought there'd be.
Oh,
it
was
loved it.
Magic kung fu.
Like, I read a few things with Doctor Strange, and it's never that fancy. I really liked the interpretation they did with the whole monk thing and all that.
Okay.
It was neat.
Has anybody seen the animated movie of Doctor Strange?
See, that's Blake's favorite animated movie as far as Marvel's concerned.
It felt the exact same as that. It was almost the same story, really. Yeah. Spoilers now.
Spoilers!
Doctor Strange dies.
Oh, no, not again. Just like Spider-Man and Iron Man and everyone else that died when we walked out of the theaters.
Except
he actually dies.
He died a lot.
Doctor Strange.
Oh, well. He died a lot, actually. Yeah. Oh my god, I didn't even think about it! He died super hard!
Oh,
I didn't know I was gonna watch Dark Souls on the screen. Did you die? Try again. Did you die? Try again.
It was amazing.
It was. I actually heard that ending was written by Rick and Morty's writer.
Yeah, because he was supposed to add some stuff. That's right.
It was a pretty good ending.
Did you know that Dormammu, his face was motion captured by Benedict Cumberbatch?
Was it?
It looked like him. Yeah,
okay.
It might have been.
At first, I thought it was Thanos just because of the whole wrinkly face.
Right.
But
honestly, it's the high cheekbones that make you think it was alien.
It was the lack of skull face and fire that made me think
it
was
I've heard theories that it's going to be like, that's his astral form in the dark dimension. When he comes to Earth, he'll look more like his comic form.
They said in the dark dimension, he doesn't have a form.
Okay.
He just made the face because it's easier to communicate with a human that way.
Okay.
Right. And that's why he took the face of Benedict Cumberbatch, because he was just mimicking the human that he saw.
Okay, that makes sense.
And now we have Pam!
Oh, good.
What was your interpretation of Doctor Strange?
Awesome. I thought it was really good. The animated movie was
on par.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like how they did the backstory between the gym and the cape.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
The cape was so...
Cape is best character.
I was so salty he didn't get the axe, though.
It was bummed that the
axe. Oh, you mean he wouldn't let him get the axe? Right. Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
In the series, he has an axe, and it's pretty rad.
Yeah, right? It's fucking great.
Because they depowered him, so he has to have his axe to
A legitimate battle axe.
Okay, so the actual gem being inside the eye, is that canon?
Yes. I don't know.
Right?
Infinity Stone being inside the eye.
In comics?
Yeah.
So. No.
Okay.
Yeah, I was pretty sure that was separated.
It's a good way to add it into the actual movies and the universe.
Well, that's what they've done the entire time. Like, the Tesseract was never a stone.
Yeah.
Vision's gem was never a stone. Like,
So let's see. We got
all
Tesseract. We got the Aether, whatever.
Yes, from Thor.
We got Loki's staff, which was...
Slash Vision's gem.
We got the Time Stone now.
Yes.
We got the one from Guardians.
Guardians
and the
power.
Orb. Yeah.
And now we got one more?
One more coming, the Soul. The Soul's the only one left.
Which is going to be in which one, you think?
Ragnarok?
People are saying Ragnarok. I think they're going to save it. It's going to be...
Wars?
It's either going to debut in Infinity War or Captain Marvel.
I don't know.
Who do you think
is going to
have
it? In
Wait.
Black Panther.
Does Thanos have one in the gauntlet already?
No.
Okay. I think Black Panther...
Shit.
Black Panther is going to focus more on vibranium than the gems.
I hope. But nevertheless, it could happen.
It's going to happen in Logan.
Shut up. How are they going to do all that, Logan? Someone explain that to me, please. Has anyone here read it?
Oh, no.
Hulk eats his family.
Well, I mean, when you're hungry...
They just changed the story dramatically to where it doesn't...
But it's the Hulk!
Did you watch Days of Future Past? It didn't make any fucking sense to the comic either.
I was a little too drunk.
That's the problem with the X-Men franchise, is that they
had
shit writers.
Oh, boy.
So, anyway.
So, what was your favorite relic?
The battle axe!
I think everybody's favorite was the cape. It was just fun.
The cape was funny.
I think that the best comparison that I've heard is the magic carpet.
No, I don't know. I like Morgo's boots.
The vaulting boots of Valtor.
I did like his staff, though.
The staff. The living tribunal. God of the Marvel Universe.
Such a good fucking name, too.
Oh, it was really good.
The cape... There's only one storyline that it had a personality in the comics, and so that's kind of a different interpretation for that, but I think it worked perfectly.
Yeah. It was almost another character.
Yeah. And it was amazing. Everyone loved the cape.
That cape, though, was canvas. Just it was similar to flat.
The magic carpet, yeah. Mm-hmm. I liked how everything kind of made sense in some way. Like, they had to have sling rings to create portals and stuff. Like, they kind of... You didn't?
Well, it was weird that they couldn't just fucking use a spell that brought them back.
I can imagine they could, if they were good enough, they could use it.
Yeah, that's probably true.
I'm sure they'll have an X movie, they'll make it to where they can just do it without the strength.
He wasn't to full potential at this point, you know?
This was strange.
He, throughout the entire movie, only casts maybe four different spells.
Right, and he's not Sorcerer Supreme yet.
There's still growth for him as a character for later movies,
exactly.
Too.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
That's how the animated movie was. It was all shield spells. I think he only casted one. Yeah.
Told you.
I love the physicality of all the spells. Just the little visual representation of sparks flying off, followed by everything that looked like magic still was physical.
Right.
Like glyphs and just from the Sorcerer Supreme, you know, she's casting fans / half circles of magic and then throwing them, and then it was very cool seeing it like
great.
That.
It was dope as fuck.
Well, I did some research into the magic of it, and they were even saying it's more like they're pulling things from different dimensions instead of just making things.
Yeah.
And so everything is physical, it just exists in a different dimension.
Well, you even see Strange do it when he's trying to cast his first, like, defense spell, and it's just strings that he's, like, pulling from his hands.
Right, yeah.
And then it turns into a whip, but it looks like he's physically pulling them out of something.
Yeah.
The visual representation of everything looked really good.
Where essentially that whip, you could say it came from a universe where plasma can be held or something.
Yes.
Where whips live.
Yeah.
No. Well, that's kind of the funny thing about multiverse theory that nobody really like expands upon is that in an infinite amount of universes, you can have an infinite amount of possibilities, which means that it's not just like, oh, look, there's a version of me that's black, or there's a version of me that's a girl, or whatever. It's also, there's a version of you that's made of poop. There's
your wife is shit.
Yeah, literally. Like, awesome. It's such a stupid concept at times. It's hilarious.
Well, this movie did kind of dive into multiverse slightly.
Yeah, to a degree. They explained it, but, you know.
I think that's set up for future movies.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
So, you know what I thought was a really cool thing? That the strings, the platinum strings that you were mentioning,
mm-hmm.
The way they did that in the movie was he had LED strips, and that's how they got the actual like glow on his face and on his body and stuff. So they had a real thing that was actually there. That's a really clever way to do it.
Oh yeah, it's amazing. And I think I said this movie's a lot like Ant-Man, and it feels low budget, but it's definitely not.
I think it feels low budget because they had like 4 sets.
Like, well, not only that,
they really didn't expand upon that. Like they made it seem like it was a huge world, even though it was only like 4 different places, and that's it. Like,
well, not only that, but I even counted them out. There are only 7 main characters. Like the only 7 characters basically in this movie.
Oh, is that including all the zealots?
No, I'm saying important people that you would.
They had names. What were they? Zealot 2,
right, yeah.
3.
Well, the strong zealot was Scott Adkins, like the world's best.
The one who made the diet?
Mm-hmm.
The one that got his ass kicked by the cape.
Oh. So he didn't make the diet?
Yeah, no, he didn't.
Okay.
Well, he was dieting. That made him too weak. He couldn't even fight the cape.
Gotta eat them carbs, dude.
But he's vegan.
But
that's the problem.
Ask him about it.
He will.
In that list,
he never shuts up.
In that list of 7 characters, also I included Dormammu and stuff like.
Oh.
And he's a small part.
You had Nurse. You had Strange.
Yes.
You had Bad Zealot. You had Librarian. You had Sidekick. You had Dormammu, and you had Sorcerer Supreme.
No, you're forgetting one. I know exactly which one you're forgetting.
What am I forgetting?
The other doctor, the shitey one that he always makes fun of.
Is he a character?
Yes.
He's
have still Bale.
He gets the chips.
Damn it.
Nicodemus West.
That's right.
He got his ass handed to him.
And he got the chips, though. That's all that matters.
And that's also not including the crippled guy that uses magic to walk.
He kind of had a part in it. Just something.
Yeah,
just
minor.
Get the
he died.
Exposition.
He died.
He didn't even die. No, he was just reduced back to a cripple.
I'm fairly certain he didn't just leave him there.
Yeah,
I'm fairly certain he did just leave him there.
I mean, that would be.
I mean, that's what's gonna kill him, anyways.
Well, he had heavily implied he was gonna kill him. I mean,
he just
was like,
magic.
There's too many sorcerers, and then
we're getting into the.
And yeah, and we'll get there.
That's true. That's true. Yeah.
I just said not to.
You triggered.
But yeah, so we'll get into each character. What'd you think of Strange?
I liked him. He was fun. He was very Tony Stark.
Oh yeah.
And I think that's kind of hilarious because, you know, the whole thing about them both playing Sherlock Holmes.
Mm-hmm.
I can't wait for them to interact with
And Rachel stuff. McAdams was in Sherlock Holmes as well.
True.
It was also true.
I said first, damn it.
I was afraid he was going to be too much Tony. He was conceited. He was cocky. But he also loses something more than Tony. You know, Tony gets his little...
Tony never really suffers.
Yeah, he doesn't suffer. He gets the little
what do you
grenade
call?
In him.
There's
that stuff.
The insurgent thing, the guys, the terrorists that captured him and kept him, like, alive, and he was eating food, and he had technology.
The big things, you know, stuff like that.
He was fine.
But, you know, I guess that also gives Doctor Strange his own little personality, because he has lost what has made him him.
Yeah.
So
where that'd be like Tony Stark
losing his reactor.
Losing his ideas and thoughts and processes of everything.
That's like if Tony Stark was Phineas Gage and just lost all of his mental capacity.
He likes his dick.
Okay.
He loves his dick.
Yeah.
Is that comic canon?
Yes.
Okay.
I mean, come on. Would it not be? I don't know.
But what about his accent?
I liked it. I think it's funny that British people think that American accents just sound like gravelly voices like Batman all the time.
I mean, listen to me.
Look at Hugh Laurie, look at Benedict Cumberbatch, look at really any British actor. They just essentially go lower with their voice and then monotone.
I'd say Americans go higher when they do a British voice.
It's not wrong, we do.
So it's equal.
It is.
Oh, I love it,
I know my American accent's always...
Except Robert Downey Jr. He went deeper with his.
Yeah, it's true.
My American accent's always bad.
The power of chakras.
I don't believe in the power of chakras.
I've seen it in gift shops.
The power of belief.
Have you seen that in a gift shop?
Teach me.
It's weird you impersonated her better than you impersonated him.
I'm sorry.
I don't think it's a bad thing.
I'm sorry.
But we've also talked about that he probably could have just done the British accent, like his normal voice, and it would have been just as good.
Honestly,
it would have worked out.
Yeah, because every time I ever read a Doctor Strange comic, I always gave him a British accent. He's always pompous and, like, suave, and he's very refined. And because of that, I feel like we just kind of implant a fake British accent because that's what Americans do.
Don't personify me with you.
And he's living in America as a surgeon, this top surgeon, but he's British.
I mean, he kind of went everywhere, or they implied that he was going around the globe doing big
surgeries.
Well,
that's afterwards. I'm just saying, just make him British in general. Which, Benedict Cumberbatch, I think his voice loses a little bit.
Do we have any British Avengers?
No.
Captain Britain?
No, I meant like British, like as in the Marvel Universe. Does anybody have a British accent?
We have an Australian accent.
That doesn't count. Are you saying that Australians are British?
No.
They were at one point.
We all were.
They went from the mainland
to the island
colonies.
You see, we got all this land for ourselves. It's called the Outback. Oh, we got fucked.
This sucks.
I think Benedict Cumberbatch's voice loses a little bit of its hypnotizing properties when he's doing the American accent.
Gay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gay for his voice, but when he's doing the American accent, it's a little too raspy.
No, I understand what you mean. Yeah, kind of, to a degree. I think that he still keeps that aspect of it. I think that he really sold it with your hypnotism of the voice. I think he sold it when he was yelling at the other doctor girl. When he was like, "You just love so much, don't you?"
There was an audible, like, groan during that scene in the actual theater.
Right. You could feel it. Like, that was legitimately good acting right there. Like,
what I enjoyed out of that scene? She didn't break down. She said, "Oh, fuck me, fuck you."
Right.
And just walks out. I actually liked her character a little bit more because of that. Because she's like, "Listen, I'm trying to help you, and you just aren't accepting anything. You do it all yourself."
We'll move on to her then. Christine Palmer was her name. What did you think of her?
I really liked her.
She took everything very well in a world of craziness that was happening.
Yeah. Well, I mean, like, when you look at the world of the Avengers already, it's
okay,
like,
I guess you're right.
Well,
I didn't
what
have
else
it.
Could go wrong? Fucking
yeah, let's
Saint
think
cool.
about that. Let's think about that for a second, though. Like, okay, so she lives in the world of the Avengers, and they have a bunch of crazy shit happening all the time. But who does that actually affect? Like, okay, let's...
They were in New
the
York.
First Avengers
a bunch of
in
people.
New York.
Didn't you see the last movie with Civil War? They told you how many people it affected. I don't remember the casualties. Casualties.
Yeah.
The one dead guy's mom.
Dead?
Yeah, one kid.
They have to be put in check. They have to.
It's all Tony's idea. He made Ultron.
He made Ultron, yeah. But yeah, I mean, I think she took it a little too well, but... I agree that, yes, it makes sense because they do live in that universe.
I want to point out, little fun fact, Christine Palmer was supposed to be the character they wanted for the Netflix shows instead of Claire Temple.
Really?
Yes.
That's
but
neat.
Marvel Studios told them that they were going to use the character.
No,
and this
we call dibs.
Yeah, exactly.
We got this.
So they had to swap her over to Claire Temple instead.
I'm okay with that because Claire's a really good character anyway.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
She's one of the best ones in that series.
Secretly fucking the entire Defenders.
Yeah! I can't wait until she shows up and bangs Iron Fist.
Right? Waiting on
with his Iron Fist.
Which is...
no. Another... I was okay with this till you said that.
Another thing real quick is... I know when Mordo showed up at the end in the after credits scene. People thought that he was Luke Cage for a second.
Because
of the hoodie.
I really did think.
Fucking hoodies everywhere.
Hoodies.
Man.
It's all the hood.
I heard people audibly say in the theater, that's Luke Cage.
Oh my god.
Like, no, why would he be here?
He's a terrible choice to put in that. Like, he has no background in mysticism.
He's just right. gonna, like, see, like, one spell and go, sweet Christmas, and then run away.
Exactly.
I understand, like, Netflix is trying to keep their own thing, and it's still the same universe, but different, like, stories and stuff like that, but... Do you think the Defenders will end up with the Avengers?
I would like
no.
to.
I mean, I think there'll be a short little snippet in Infinity Wars where they'll be like fighting, and it might be like a wide pan of whatever is getting affected, like
yeah.
whatever city. Probably New York, because I really love the fuck that place over.
It's true. I feel bad.
And Daredevil's like, I'm here too.
Daredevil's trying to feel his way around.
This isn't what I remember.
Where's my office? Shit!
And this one, they fucked up. They fucked up London a bit.
Yes, yeah, a little bit.
They did the
London,
same
though,
thing in Thor,
the mirror dimension.
They did the same
That's
thing
what...
in Thor Dark World. London
yeah,
got
yeah,
fucked
yeah.
up pretty
exactly.
hard.
Hong Kong 2, that one street.
Yeah, but it all
that,
that one street.
Yeah.
Oh, the reverse time. It didn't get fucked up.
Right, none of that happened.
The entire sanctum in London was destroyed.
Fair
like, that's
point.
One of the ones that was actually
that's
destroyed.
That's just like one building.
Yet at the end,
True.
The sanctum itself looked like it was getting built back together pretty well.
I like to imagine they're just like the mansion in X-Men. It just they always fucking blow
it's
up.
It's always
oh, yeah.
every week.
Constantly.
Oh, we lost another one. Fuck.
Going back to Christine Palmer for a second, I wish she had a little bit more screen time or so, because
yeah.
it felt like she
yeah.
just came in on scenes to aggravate him or to help him, and then
she
left.
She seemed like a plot device.
Yeah.
This movie also enforcing don't text and drive at the same time.
Yes.
Heavily.
Don't MRI.
No, don't
MRI. Doctoring and driving.
No doctoring
text
and driving.
All you want.
Oh,
doctoring
and,
and driving, killing Doctor Strange's more and more.
Not killing.
Oh, sorry.
Maiming.
I did look up those references, though.
Rhodey.
And then, nope. They said it happened before Civil War.
What?
The entire training of him was supposed to be a year, so that means that it takes place before Civil War.
No way.
No,
it was, he was talking about an augmented suit and a guy paralyzed from the legs down.
Yeah, that was Rhodey.
That had to be
Rhodey. No. Because they asked the director if it was Rhodey and if it was the guy from Iron Man 2 that was turned around in the hammer tech. He said it was neither. Like, those references
what?
Weren't
that.
Specifically
no.
anybody.
Bullshit. I'm calling
If you're saying that this movie happened before... Like,
Civil War.
Not just Civil War, Iron Man 2?
No. That just the beginning
okay.
happened before Civil War. At the end, they said it's current time.
I don't know. It makes it sound like he learned really quick. There was
yeah.
really no...
He had the photographic memory.
Photographic memory.
Before I heard that, I thought he learned too quick. But saying that it was over a year, that makes it more believable for me.
I mean, if you're saying that that's the actual canon, then yes, it makes it more believable that he caught it, like, that quick.
They didn't portray it in the movie too well, that time was passing.
I mean, he went from struggling with a gate to pulling books out the shelf on the,
yeah.
on the library.
Said
really good.
By the way, that Beyonce scene fucking on point.
That was
you
great.
You have heard her. And
okay,
his
yeah, yeah.
The scene at the end was perfect.
So let's go on to Wong then. What do you think of Wong?
Wong was fucking
great.
MLG, fucking amazing guy.
I was sad because I was like, oh, I like this guy. I'll hate it when he died. Then he died and came back.
Right.
He got
that
better.
Permanent. Yeah.
I want to point out, I was looking up fun facts about this movie, and one of them was, oh, this is the first superhero movie where two actors have the same name of Benedict, and also an actor plays a character with the same name of Wong. It's like, of course, it's the first movie to fucking do that. What the fuck are you talking
it's
about?
All so beautiful, minus the whole Chinese oppression.
Oh.
It's great. I mean, it looks beautiful.
I love you. You horrible person, you.
Hey, I don't agree with it, but, you know.
So, in the comics, Wong... can't perform magic.
Did he ever
I think that
really
was ever
perform
thing.
Magic?
No.
I mean, like he had the relic, but he didn't really perform magic at all.
That's true, he didn't.
I never saw him make a gate or anything.
And
he had everybody else.
They did specify that relics contain their own magic.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
right.
So yeah, I mean, it's still canon technically.
Do you think he named his stick the name, or do you think it was actually given? Because I feel like that was something he made up, like, to make it sound super cool and badass, because there's no way that's like the original name. Like, no one thought of it.
Like the Staff of the Living Tribunal.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, like,
it sounds too
The Living Tribunal again is it's the literal god. Of
yeah,
Marvel.
I know.
So like maybe he made it up, but I mean I'd believe it if he didn't.
No, the Living Tribunal one was different. He had one that was like the Staff of Cagliostro or something.
Yeah, the names are ridiculous.
Yeah, that's what I love about it. It's so great.
Right, it is fun.
The eye has a fun name. I think the Cloak of Levitation needs a new name, but you know what.
Cloak of Levitation's alright. It's very Harry Potter.
It did more than levitate.
It murdered.
Murder Cloak.
The
good
cloak.
Song title.
Cloak of Murder.
Clock song.
While we're on that topic, I think that Strange took that, like, killing thing too hard. He didn't really kill the guy. Like, it wasn't his fault.
And it was self-defense.
His cape did most of the work, really. Like...
No, he killed his spirit, though.
Oh, no. Like, that doesn't happen to us on a daily basis.
Mine's been dead for years.
I'd like to think mine's okay.
No.
Oh, no.
Shut up.
No, it's not.
If you go to church doesn't mean your spirit's fine.
Hey, you want
to
watch something?
No.
I never kill anybody. I'm for healing.
It's true, yeah. He has an O, like, his operating record's perfect.
Mr. Doctor.
It's kind of stacked perfect. He doesn't pick anything
exactly.
That he
and
really thinks. No, that guy's dead.
Yeah, right.
It's
not a perfect record. That's a surgeon's perfect record, which means that he just didn't take a case that he couldn't do.
Right.
If he had a perfect record, it would be that he took any case and then just was perfect with it, which technically isn't the case. Nevertheless.
I would imagine that like once he got started and he got like his first couple under the belt, he's like... Okay, this is going good. I don't want to mess it up. And then he decided to take on that role.
5-0. I'm doing pretty good.
But at the same time, he's ballsy enough to do that first surgery where he gets the bullet out of the guy without like any type of guidance.
Free hand, as they called it. That was really cool.
Right. I just want to say, too, this was a thing I saw, a continuity error, I guess, where they were saying that the guy that had the bullet in his head, they sent him in through an MRI, which would have killed him because it's magnetic.
Pulled through, yeah.
Right.
And
well, no, it depends on the bullet.
No,
bullet's
you're right.
Magnetic.
True. They did say that when I was reading.
Were they
that
worried
thing.
About the magnetic, or were they worried about the lead poisoning?
They thought the lead poisoning caused the brain damage. And
okay.
They were worried about it killing him.
They didn't know the bullet was still in there.
How to get shot?
With a gun.
Oh, with a gun. Thank you.
Welcome.
Moving on.
Luke Cage flicked a bullet at him.
It bounced off.
Yeah, he was just walking across the street when Luke Cage got shot at.
Yeah.
That was in Christmas Addicts.
He's just sitting there, sweet Christmas, what the fuck was that?
I
think that he says fuck.
Yes.
Well, in the comics he curses a lot. He just, you know, leaves it out, his comics.
Let's move on to Mordo.
Mordo, I don't know. I mean, like, I see what they were trying to do with him. Give him a personality before they made him a villain.
They were trying to make him Bucky.
Yeah.
Right away.
Exactly. Okay, that's a good interpretation of it, too.
Yeah.
Because he really wasn't trying to be evil. He just didn't want to die.
Right.
I didn't necessarily dig it, but, you know.
Where does Mordo go in the comics?
He's always been just evil.
He
wanted to kill magicians.
Okay.
He becomes a baron or something. I don't know what, but...
Carl Mordo.
Are there any good barons?
His first name's Carl.
It is.
Marvel Universe.
I was going to say, is there anybody that's been titled Baron? Baron of... happiness or good times. No, they're always like
they're
always
like evil.
Evil.
The Baron of Sex and Wine.
Oh, dude, I want to be that guy.
Dionysus.
That's the one.
That's the one. That's the guy.
I want to be him when I grow up.
I enjoyed Mordo.
When I grow up, I want to be the Baron of Sex and Wine.
Where he had this, he was wanting to be righteous.
Right.
And then once he realized people were corrupt, he's like, fuck people. We need
people
to kill them.
Suck.
And so, yeah, I liked Mordo.
Not the greatest choice, in my opinion.
Oh, yeah.
But overall, you know, great. Like, you know, he's a good character. He was fun.
Right. Okay, we'll move on to the ancient one.
She was... Alright. She also seemed like a plot device.
Yeah.
She wasn't Mr. Miyagi.
Very linear feeling.
I liked that she wasn't Mr. Miyagi in a way. She was more free-thinking. I guess.
It wasn't a bad role, and it wasn't a bad actor, and for a new type of take on it, it was still okay. But in the same sense, I guess it's the same way that I felt about, you know, Nick Fury. really? We're going here? Okay. That's not the Nick Fury I know.
That's cool. Right.
I don't remember Nick Fury ever. Okay. Well, fine. Let's go. And then, like, you watch, it's like, okay, no, it's fine. It's fine.
They made the right choice. I understand now. I don't think they've miscast a single movie yet.
No, everybody was very well cast in this.
Although I will say I did prefer old Rhodey to new Rhodey.
I just thought about something for the timeline. Did you guys see Avengers Tower in the skyline?
Yeah, it was there.
So that means this has to be still after Avengers. Damn it. No, that still isn't.
That's still a long period of time.
It's still a long time.
Well, technically, that's 2012 on. So there's 4 years there it could take place.
Damn it.
And there was no hints. So this could take place at any point.
It's magic. It's one of those things where even if it took place at any particular time, he has a fucking Infinity Stone that controls time. It can happen whenever the hell he feels
like.
He still has it.
I did like seeing him in the astral world still reading while he's sleeping.
That was pretty cool.
Like that just showing him also.
Why he picked it up so quickly. Because he never stopped.
Something that I hate so much is penises all over the place.
All over.
Everywhere.
I just want to watch a good Marvel movie and dick.
But there's articles all over the place that's just like, 1001 cool Easter eggs from Doctor Strange you may have missed. And then it's like, oh, did you know that the Eye of Agamotto was an Infinity Stone? It's like, of course, they said it.
It's in the movie. Thank you. And next.
Did you know that Doctor Strange was a surgeon before he became Doctor Strange?
Yes, I did.
What?
What about...
Fun fact, you didn't notice.
Oh, okay.
I noticed it.
It was there, they said it. They show him doing surgery stuff.
They told me I didn't notice it, though. Okay.
I hate those things. I hate them. I don't bother looking at them anymore because they're all stupid.
Going back to the ancient one, though, one of my favorite scenes is when she's about to die and she's in her astral form staring out in the city and Doctor Strange is next to her in his astral form. And in 3D especially, when it's showing like kind of an overlap, you can see that she's closer, he's further away, but you still see through both of them and see them both.
That was really good effect.
It was so amazing.
Just the line, here I am, so scared, stretching one moment into 1,000 moments. Like that line in general was just like, oh, yeah, she is gonna die. She's the ancient one.
For real?
Yes. And this is happening. And it happened just, it wasn't spectacular, it wasn't amazing, it just happened in a normal...
She just disappeared.
Almost mid-sentence.
Not even that, like her like the actual act of her falling. They just didn't stop it, she fell. Yeah. And then...
Oh, right.
Right down.
Well, that's what they did in Civil War 2 with Rhodey. Oh, yeah. He fell out of the sky.
Yeah. That hit was so rough, because she hits that balcony just...
Yeah.
Glass.
It was the same exact feeling.
What killed her? The glass? The bleeding?
Who knows?
The impact?
Probably the impact.
Any number. The answer is...
All of it.
The answer is a broken heart.
Oh.
Shut up. Can we
edit that out?
Nope.
I like that she was corrupt, too.
Yeah, she was not a good
She was drawing from the... Well,
was she corrupt, or corrupt. She
was
more
bending the rules?
That's what corruption
that's
is.
That's kind of the
to
story,
degree,
though.
That's Doctor Strange in a nutshell, though. He doesn't do things right. He's a bad boy.
Yeah, and you know, that was kind of the storyline, though. Sometimes, in order to fix everything and do the right, you have to bend the rules.
Right. Was Doctor
Teaching
Strange
all the
corrupt
kids
for
to
saving all of those people by bending the rules?
Well, that's what Mordo came back to do, where he's just like, they are bending the rules. Fuck these guys, I'm gonna kill them.
Right.
Well, I get that that's what he's doing now. That's his thing. I don't consider that corruption just because that's very black and white. That's very Mordo. It's not really how things work. To do something, sometimes you have to bend the rules.
It's true. For reals.
That's what I like about Mordo, though, is that he's technically in the right, where it's just like, don't break rules, these guys are breaking rules.
Right.
Well, that's your typical relatable villain.
Right.
Like, I don't think that, really, most of the villains are just misunderstood people of some...
Well, they should be.
Mordo's just Judge Dredd.
That's what I liked about,
Caecilius.
Yeah, Caecilius.
Yeah, let's get to him.
Thank you for getting that idea. Well, like, he sits there and explains everything to him. It's like, okay, that makes sense. I can see where he's coming from. But, like, to think that, like, there's not a downside is, like...
Right.
Don't be fucking stupid.
Which is honestly one of my favorite things was with Mordo. So with Mordo, they mentioned how with that sort of thing, there is a price. Yeah, that's my favorite thing about magic as far as fiction's concerned, is that it's warping reality, but it always has a magical backlash.
Right. And I appreciate always that. Fucks and, you up.
And Doctor Strange never had that up until currently.
Recently, yeah.
Yeah, there's a secret society of monks that tank all the shit, the ill effects that come with magic, and he didn't know about it at all. And I love that that exists, because it shows that he does have his limitations. He's not just this most, like, the most OP character that exists.
You know what I think they might do instead in the movies? Yeah, like, right. Go to the Apple scene, where he's rewinding time, making it new,
yeah,
and
right.
Fast-forwarding it and making it rot. Where he's drawing those apples from different dimensions.
Yeah.
So he rewinds time, that new apple is taken from this dimension where now they switched, let's say. So now, say that he wanted a car. He makes a car appear out of nowhere. The dimension he took that car from...
now it doesn't have a car.
Yeah.
Some guy's like, what the fuck? I know I parked my car here.
Right. Well, I was saying make it worse, where he's driving on the highway, his car just disappears, and he hits the ground going 80 miles per hour.
But
so
that's
now,
not my Doctor Strange, so I don't have to worry about that guy.
Fuck that guy, really, honestly.
Who cares?
No, I hope they do what they did in the new comic, which is, like, through the entirety of the new series, they talk about, like, there's an elephant in the room, or the basement, rather. And, like, it's basically this entity that they put all the suffering and pain Doctor Strange goes through whenever he uses all his magic. They just take it out of him and put it into this guy. And so this guy's, like, the most fucked up, disgusting creature you could ever imagine. In all black, like, he looks like the ghost from... Howl's Moving Castle. And, like, he's his own character, he has his voice, and his sole purpose is to kill Strange.
Mm.
That's what he's
nice.
Decided. I've gotta do this thing. Fuck this guy, and he has every right to think so.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Well, I just think in the movies, instead of having monks take his... instead of having monks take his pain, or, like, all the magic that he does... Instead, they'll just say that when he takes something from this alternate universe, he may be affecting lives or something in the alternate universe.
Right, and that's a possibility. It's, you know, it's a pretty cool concept in general, but
it's good writing. Can we talk about the ending real quick about that in that same sense?
I have one more character.
Okay.
Dormammu.
Wasn't that bad of a guy? What did he really do? He killed an intruder in his home.
Multiple times.
Home invasion.
There's one more thing I wanted to say about Caecilius too. One of my favorite things was the trap that Doctor Strange threw at him that made him forced him onto the ground and
I don't know why, but all I could see was like Isaac Clarke's
suit.
Just looked like he put it on backwards.
My question is, why don't we use those always?
Yeah.
They're
all criminals.
Because there was just one.
Avengers 1 when Loki's in the airship.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just put him in that.
That's true. It humiliates him and keeps him down.
It's like, no, that's specifically for Hulk.
They're calling up all of the monks. Do you guys know where he put it? Hey, do you remember where we put that shackle thing?
Fuck, I'm.
It's in New York. I don't see it around here. He's looking at
it.
I
just.
No.
Can't find it. He's got like someone in it. I don't know
where it is.
Hey, look at us, Tony. Hey, Tony.
Tony doesn't know either.
Have you seen the Straight Jacket thing? Yeah, no, he hasn't seen it either.
It's baffling, really. It's a mystery.
Yeah, it doesn't have legs. It can't just walk out of here like some other stuff.
But Dormammu, though, I love the look of the Dark Universe.
Yeah, it looked awesome. It looked really weird, foreign, and
it's
perfect.
He didn't really look like... You already mentioned that he doesn't have a form. He took on the form because of Benedict. But, I mean, like, he didn't look menacing. Like, I expected more stylish scariness.
Yeah, I can see that.
Like, he's supposed to be, like, one of the most terrifying beings in the multiverse.
Well, he'll be back. He'll definitely be back.
Right.
I guess I was expecting more of a monstrous face or just something not human-looking.
Not multicolored rainbow man.
Well, that's the thing. Like, we know Dormammu and we know Thanos and stuff like that, but like even me, I was just watching it and I was like, is that Thanos?
Mm-hmm.
Like someone who doesn't look into these movies and stuff, they're gonna see Dormammu and like, okay, So is there any connection with this guy? Because, I mean, he was purple. He had the face kind of like that. And he was an all-being that was right there. But in the same sense, he was still similar looking in a way. I don't know. It was still, like, for the actual, like, threat of intergalactic, amazing...
Planetary...
No. For, like, a interstellar multi-conqueror, he was still threatening, and the ways that he just dealt with Strange like it was nothing.
Right.
Yeah. Like, Strange didn't have anything. Anytime he tried doing anything, it was like, oh, that lasted like 1 second.
Right.
Dormammu, I've come to bargain.
Dormammu! Like,
Dormammu!
And I love that it took halfway through the second time for Dormammu to just be like, you've come to... Wait, what?
Wait, what the hell?
Wait, hold on. Has anybody been here? Yeah. But that's what I was getting ready to say was, like, since we're here now, is that an alter-dimensional Strange that's coming? Is that a new multiverse Strange that keeps popping out? Or is it Strange locked in a time loop that he just resets?
It was the time loop.
Okay.
Yeah.
I was going to say, hide behind the pile of dead Strange.
You're welcome for that reference.
I don't know. It was a cool scene to see that's, like, you know, it was once again mind over actual power,
right,
and stuff like that. And that just shows how smart he was.
Because time didn't exist in the Dark Dimension.
Yeah, right.
And so he turned on the time gem once he was on that first planet. Then he hopped over to the orb. Then he hopped over to the other one closer to Dormammu, said he had to bargain. Then when he was killed, he just reverted back to where time started.
Yeah, when he
because
started
that's
the spell.
Where the loop ended.
Okay.
So it was just a time loop.
He died super hard.
Oh, yeah.
A lot.
Yeah. He was super dead.
And he remembers all of them, too.
Yeah.
Like, I liked that they made both of them conscious of what was happening.
Yeah.
Like, you retain all that information when in actuality you probably wouldn't. But it just shows how impressive that kind of logic is. It's metaphysical. It's very entertaining.
I know it's the climax of the movie, and I know that it was sped up just for that. But... if it was just that many times, Dormammu folded really quick.
Right, yeah.
Okay, no, I'm done with this. I know I'm all powerful and everything, but this is annoying.
Which is really kind of what it was. It was just, wow, this is really annoying. I don't like this. And then he just got bored and was like, fine, I'll let you go.
Well, they pulled that directly from Guardians, too, where the actual final fight is just, it leads up to a joke instead of this amazing action set piece.
And Guardians is one of the best, if not the best, in the MCU.
Yeah.
It's up there. It was so different compared to everything else, but it was similar. And it was enough to where, even though it was completely across the galaxy, somewhere that didn't have any interaction with the MCU whatsoever, but you still felt like it was. And it was just its own entity. The music was amazing. Since then, their music, even in Doctor Strange, I noticed the music was amazing.
Oh, yeah.
The score was amazing.
Right. Like, they did really good. And it was, and I think that since Guardians of the Galaxy, they've upped their game on their, at least the musical level, 100-fold. Like, they have just done a lot better in that aspect.
Can we talk about the 8th character that we forgot?
Who's that?
The Doctor?
No.
The guy who got the chips?
Stan Lee.
No. Oh yeah, Stanley's pretty.
His little cameo. Did anybody catch what he's reading?
It had DNA on it. I saw that.
No, it wasn't DNA. No. It was the Art of Perception.
Did you ever hear the theory of him being the Watcher?
Yes,
I
love it.
If that's canon, this is right.
Well, he has the like 40 cameos written.
Exactly.
Yeah.
How could he be everywhere? How is he always there?
He's a Sentinel.
Sentinels are based off of Stan Lee.
Oh, no! I would watch that so long.
Excelsior.
Excelsior, you dirty mutant trash.
I want this to be canon right now. Stop what you're drawing. Draw Stan Lee as a Sentinel.
we broke him super hard.
I don't know what just happened to me. I didn't like it though.
I'm very drawn
meant me.
Good.
Well, usually Raimi's the one who makes terrible puns, and I always hate
Excuse
him.
Me?
Who made the title?
I did.
Oh.
I just draw the stuff, man.
Yeah, what'd you think of the story?
You know, very typical story as far as the overall thing. I think it was the presentation that made it really good.
Oh, definitely. That's what everyone loves.
The writing was good. The jokes were well written, like they always are. It was, I think it was less about the story at this point and more about the presentation. It was just very well done. It showed a character who is very into himself, like I said, it's a typical story. It's nothing impressive or new. It's just, like, the way they did it made it much better. Like, the trippiness of it all, the visuals.
How much more striking do you think it would have been in a world without Inception?
Oh, a thousand times.
Yeah. Like, that's a thing. Like, if anybody wanted to know, like, what's Doctor Strange? I go, well, if you want to see the movie, it's like Inception with superpowers and magic.
Well, Inception
was probably the last movie that we could really say was super trippy. Like Doctor Strange and Inception are what I feel like the Alice in Wonderland movies should have been.
That's good. But even in the world of Inception, where we are watching this movie that all this trippy stuff happens, just the first scene with the Ancient One bending
on the wall
and just seeing everything envelop on itself and then just reform like nothing. And everybody's still walking around like nothing is happening. Mm. That was still a striking scene and way, way good of a scene. That good grammar.
Way good of a scene to see
like in the first part. Like this is what you're getting into.
Oh yeah. They nailed the opening and then they kill the librarian.
Those must have been really, really sharp knives that he never used again.
That's very true. He used them.
I understood that reference.
He used them in the prequel comic.
That was a good joke, yes.
Those knives.
He fought with them in the prequel comic.
Oh, okay, that's cool.
Which was, it's awesome.
So why did he switch to the invisible, like, wispy sword?
Because those are cooler.
You're not wrong.
Which, when I saw those, I just imagined that he was reaching into the mirror dimension and pulling like
it looked like shards of glass.
Which is probably what they would.
Did
say
anyone else think it looked like a Klingon sword at first? Just the shape of
the
it.
Atlas.
Yeah, it looks like a Atlas.
I don't Star Trek.
It's alright. It's fine.
It's fine. Please get out now.
But then
it's fine.
You may leave at any time.
They also included
right now.
They also included the wand chooses the wizard type thing where the relics have to kind of choose you to protect.
Not everything is Harry Potter.
You
know, in the same sense of not everything's Harry Potter, this was pretty Harry Potter.
It was cool, honestly.
I want to talk about
drugs.
Sex.
How many drugs were you on when you saw the movie?
Kids,
I was only on 3 hits of acid.
I know that you
are doing drugs
and think that drugs are cool. But they are.
They are. They're amazing. You should always use them because they'll make life so much better.
Don't leave with a setup like that, man.
There's a time and place for everything, and that place is college.
And so now that we're done with drugs, I want to move on to what was the worst scene in the movie? What did you hate the most? Yes.
What I didn't like was how everyone else in the entire movie, except Doctor Strange, couldn't fight anyone.
Mm-hmm.
They were all...
Everybody was a bitch.
Everyone was a bitch. And, like, here's this guy who has no fighting experience up until the point where he joined this, you know...
Right, and then fucking Mordo's, like, calling him out on it. Like, oh, you can't fight, you're a little bitch.
No one else can!
It's like, really? You're the only fucking person in here who, like, didn't see me kill a bunch of people. Like, I fought off the whole enemy.
Even Wong seemed like he was gonna do fine, but look at what happened to fucking him.
He got a stake through his heart. And then Rubble set on top of him.
No, like, he walked out all confident, he pulled out his relic, he's like, I'm gonna get some shit done.
Impaled on random rocks.
And also, Doctor Strange, when he was being jumped in that alley in Tibet, and he went to... he punched a guy and it hurt his hand.
That was a very good... That's something else that I noticed. At the end, his hands still weren't healed.
No, they're not.
That's really cool.
I like that. And he put the broken watch on, and that was like... I thought... I saw the broken watch in the very beginning. I was like, okay, he's going to learn how to fix it.
Mm.
He never did.
Nope.
He didn't need to.
That was really good.
He stayed broken.
That's...
Fuck you.
Like his watch.
That was really good.
You did it, Marvel.
You did it.
Woo! Yay!
It's not the suit. It's the man inside the suit.
That place, it was called a Camartage.
Yeah.
But, so he was in there, and I love how the Ancient One brought out the guy with only...
One hand stub.
Just that big middle finger.
Oh, you can't do it with your hands? How about this guy?
It's not your hands. Aww. It's because you're a bitch.
Well, no. That's not true, though. They should have brought out someone with Parkinson's or something.
Here's
Jamie Foxx.
What they should have done was there's a character in the new Doctor Strange comics in the bar without doors. There's the bartender is just a floating head.
Nice.
A head in a jar.
He can do it.
He's a head. Like, in one scene, he's fighting off guys with a sawed-off shotgun.
Wow.
He's just levitating. Boom!
But it wasn't the fact that his hands were destroyed. It was that he was shaking. He couldn't do it.
Michael J. Fox.
And so, yeah, Michael J. Fox come out, perform some spells.
I said Jamie Foxx. I was like, that's not the right one.
You know, I heard you say it, and I was just like, that's probably a reference to something I don't know.
I think you're a shade off.
Wait. So that's my movie. That one.
You make one comment, and all of a sudden, everyone thinks you're an asshole.
Okay. I was gonna say racist.
Asshole. I mean, I am, but they don't need to know that.
So what was your worst scene, then?
My worst scene, the one that I hated the most, is the guy that he went to, Jonathan was his name, the guy that was crippled, that used magic to make himself walk, and he told him to go to Camartage.
Yeah.
Where, to me, Doctor Strange...
How did he find it?
How did he find that guy?
How did he know it was in Nepal?
I mean, it sounds kind of...
Like, he's just like, hey, I went to a place called Camartage.
Okay.
Later. That's it. That's all you're
going to get. So is that on 42nd
or
Malcolm X?
Right.
But it's an Iron Fist type thing, where he needs to go out there and find it himself, not be told. What if in Iron Fist, someone just goes up to Iron Fist, he's like, Kunlun, you'll fucking learn shit, there's dragons. Wouldn't you be a little disappointed?
To be fair, that is kind of how it happens. It was, well, like, Kunlun, it comes around once every 10 years.
It cooms around?
Kunlun.
And Danny Rand's parents, well, his dad knew about it because... He was trained by a former Iron Fist, and he wanted to become an Iron Fist. So
he
spent his entire life. So a guy didn't necessarily. He's like, hey, it comes around in the Himalayan mountains. That's all you really know. You just gotta look around near Mount Everest, and you'll find it. And it's I guess I'll just scale all of these mountains, and you know that's kind of what happens. And then parents got eaten by wolves.
Yeah, but it was his. Dad was being trained, like it wasn't just
right,
he was walking around the cities just like, I want to learn martial arts, where should I go? And they're just like, oh, go to Kunlun, it's a pretty badass place.
Go to Colleen Wings.
And so the like if
I'm
exposition,
I got
here's
it.
Where the plot's gonna go.
Right. So I just hated that guy, and that guy was just a setup for the after credits scene to have his power taken away.
Yeah.
And
no, I agree.
He served no purpose.
Exactly. They could have showed Mordo do another evil thing than go to that guy.
And when he goes to find out, all they had to show was a fucking Google search.
Right?
That could have replaced that guy completely.
He did say that he was fluent in Google Translate, though, so.
Yeah.
I like how they were recommending the font to read the translated text at the end, too. I'd read this one in Sanskrit. I'm sorry, I'm more of a wingding stuff guy.
Do you guys have a worse scene?
Honestly, I've been trying to think of it for a while now.
Yeah, at least...
I think my worst scene was, I understand that Mordor was like...
Mordor?
Gosh, I can't think.
Yes.
Cool.
Yes. So Mordor. So when Mordor was there, just his utter devotion to the Ancient One, and as soon as he sees her with the symbol on her head, tapping into dark powers and stuff, instant heel turn. I am done with you. You're devoted to this person.
Right.
Years of your life.
He was even arguing with Doctor Strange when he was saying that she can't be trusted.
Yeah.
And like, he was just like, no, we have to trust her.
Whoa.
Why?
You do meth? No, I can't follow
Hold
you
on.
Now.
Everything else is cool, but that thing, that's kind of fucked up.
You're a lefty.
Too much.
You're a lefty.
Oh, no, we can't have your kind here.
I don't believe in the power of lefties.
Have you ever found a lefty in a gift shop?
Yes.
So yeah, that'd have to be my thing. Just like he was built up as a character, like you know that his morals are straight and he follows her,
right,
but then like he didn't even question her, he just instantly ran away.
Well, she was dead at that point,
no,
so.
Don't worry about that. Don't worry about
still.
He didn't even show up in the astral world saying, so what the fuck?
What the fuck, bro? That was honestly part of my least favorite thing. I didn't like that she was drawing on the dark dimension for immortality. I feel like they could have, any spell should have been able to do that. Magic is very versatile. I feel
well,
like
the Eye of Agamotto is time. She
right.
could have just.
She could have just turned that on.
Yeah.
Put like, that on loop.
Yeah.
Put that shit on loop, yo.
Yeah,
like Groundhog's Day.
I mean, I guess wouldn't have the same, like, you know, drawback as the whole, oh, I got immortality.
Oh, yeah, I'm kind of fucking evil, yo.
She's
just
not,
a little.
That's just it. She's not evil at all. Like,
nope.
What did she do? She lived long. So
she's
she
a cleric who learned
fuck
one
evil
black.
On to live long, I guess.
Yeah, but they already said in the movie that if you mess with time, it can fuck up everything.
Right.
She didn't.
She did. By living long, that's messing with time.
And here's
that's
the
messing
thing, though.
Time.
Yeah, it is.
Not really.
But
here's the thing, though. When she talks about trying to see into the future, she can only see up to that point. So no matter what she did, if she did drop from the dark world again, it still would have ended right there.
True.
That was her cutoff. That was the world saying, all right, you're done with your
Well,
shit.
She said that she saw through many dimensions, and that was the
but,
furthest
yeah,
she could get.
That's
yeah.
the last part she could see.
Because she used all the other dimensions to her, you know, abilities.
So if she didn't use dark magic, though, then she would have died way before that, because she probably
yeah.
saw... Oh,
should
I'll fucking
not so ancient.
Oh, I probably shouldn't have used those stairs.
Elevators are dangerous. Shit.
Fuck. All right. Note to self.
No.
Don't eat peanuts.
You know what was really clever?
No amount of magic can stop allergies.
You know what was really clever? It was the scene where they were running from them. Whatever.
Caecilius.
Yeah, Caecilius.
Mm-hmm.
They were running from Kate Beckinsale, and just like in the mirror dimension. And it was really smart because on the set, they only had 6 or 7 things that were actually physically there.
Yeah.
Because they were just running on scaffolding at one point in time. And they just, like, digitally altered, like, all this scaffolding going through the sky and stuff. It was just, it's a smart way to film it.
I will have a recommendation. If you haven't seen Doctor Strange yet and you're thinking about it, if you have motion sickness, don't go.
At least not
go.
3D.
Go.
You will not have
it.
A good time.
Yes, you will.
Well, that was... what you were saying, Brandon.
Yes, sweet.
The set pictures had them doing that, where they're running away from them in on the street in New York.
I was looking for the scene where they did that little queer hop.
Yeah.
I was waiting for it all the time. I wanted that hop.
They
I
just,
know, I wanted it so bad.
They just edited it out.
They probably did.
This has been memed too much.
No. Right. There's no such thing as memed too much.
There
so,
is?
No.
Even though the internet doesn't want to believe it.
Beautiful.
So is there a best part that you like?
You know...
Yes!
I liked a lot of it, and so I don't know if I could pick a best
to be fair,
part.
You can't really ask him. He likes everything.
I like everything.
No. You don't understand.
He
you
likes
know how
everything.
You have movies that you hate?
He doesn't.
He doesn't. He had Spanglish, and he likes it now.
Yeah, he watched
I'm
it.
Joking.
It was hilarious.
That's a good movie, though.
Yeah, he
you're the
said
second.
How?
You're the second guest we've had that said that was a good movie. So thank you.
Yeah, I put it on as a joke, as a fucking joke, and we ended up watching it.
It was bad.
No, don't turn it off.
Great.
I want to see what happens.
It wasn't horrible or anything, but it was just bad to watch him change his mind because it's
truly
just,
invested.
Right, exactly.
It was
like,
hilarious.
The only thing in his life he's ever been invested in, and he's like, eh.
Yeah, now he's just like, it exists.
Okay, well, if I had to say one favorite part, it was the fight scene back in time.
Yeah.
That was, like, the very last fight
oh,
scene.
Oh, yeah.
Where it is
yeah.
literally getting put back together
and they're getting
from the explosion.
From the ashes.
And then, like, you know, you throw a guy into the wall, and now he's in the wall.
Yeah.
And then, like,
well,
you know, the bamboo
like...
scaffolding that's actually falling up and getting rebuilt.
I loved that, but I didn't like
the
that
bitch who gets stuck in the fish tank.
I didn't like
yeah.
that. Yeah,
all powerful magic, and now I'm stuck in a fish tank.
Right. What the fuck am I doing? Oh, wait, that's right. Magic!
That's part of the thing that I didn't
that's
like.
That's how lobsters can't get out.
Yeah.
Magic's their way out. Like,
she had the rubber bands.
You'd rather they be stuck.
She's got rubber bands on her hands like a lobster.
I can't do it.
No, my magic. What weakness? Rubber bands.
That's what they should have done. That's what they should have done when Doctor Strange was talking about how he had tremors.
Yeah. Oh, fuck that cage thing they threw on him.
Oh, and God. Then
the rubber bands?
Instead of having the guy with no arms, they just brought out a guy with rubber bands.
Okay, he pulled out his hands and his lobster claws and rubber bands.
I tried to remember this, Steven, but our worst enemy.
One of the girls went into the water.
Yeah, she gets.
Casey Elias was
put in the wall. Wasn't another one put in like glass or water or something like
that? She was just put behind. One was put in the fish tank.
Yes.
One was put behind a glass window. Like,
yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's a glass window.
Like, you could break it. You could physically break it if you wanted to.
And then they didn't show him again.
Right. No.
No, they didn't.
They pop back up.
Yeah. When he like starts walking up to him after they kind of lose, I guess.
Oh.
And they're like, oh hey, we're still here.
And then Doctor Strange flies away.
A little shardy, but.
Doctor
Strange
flies away, and then Casey Elias is just like, look, Doctor Strange doesn't even believe in you anymore.
And he shows up behind him like, surprise, bitch!
Rubber bands.
The one weakness of every wizard.
Superman has kryptonite.
Doctor Strange has rubber bands. Luke Cage has Chitauri bullets.
Yeah, bullets that can drill through stuff.
You can't have bullets. That's Quicksilver's weakness.
I had a question about that. Mm. What do you think would happen if Luke Cage got just hit by a Chitauri ship? Just like a rain.
Oh, yeah, fuck him.
I mean, he'd be super dead, right?
Well, Ronan was hit by the Guardian ship, and he survived, but he had a power stone.
Ronan was also kind of, you know,
superpowered.
Yeah.
Yeah, this guy's just a fucking freak.
Like, he wasn't just bulletproof.
Bulletproof thug.
Yeah, that's it.
It's really all on the hoodie.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Kevlar hoodie.
So, the after credits scene.
Oh, speaking of which, my favorite part of the scene, because no one asked me. Fuck you, Raimi.
Right.
Credits.
Shut up. It's always on credits with you.
The credits was just like,
that joke's been built up for 3 days now.
Nice. The joke is that he loves the credits.
That's what anyone asked me. Yeah.
The credit scenes.
Okay.
Not the design of the credits. Just when it turns to black and there's just names. Down.
Well, it worked on me. There you go.
Yeah.
The Thor after credit scene though.
That was
awesome.
That was directed by the director of
the new Thor. That was legitimately my favorite part of the whole movie, was that after credit scene.
My favorite part is, it seemed like Thor didn't exactly know what he was dealing with, because he's just like, confused the entire time. Like,
yet also accepted.
Well, the thing
I can't complain, it's beer.
Right. Thor knows about magic. He knows that it exists, but like his, you know, Loki excelled in it. But Thor has no fucking clue how to
use
it.
He just hits shit.
So yeah, he does know what it is, but he's like, free beer.
He's even accepted that, like, you know, magic is technology just with a different type of
look to it.
Yeah, like magic and technology flow together.
Right.
And it's just the knowledge.
In my world, they're one of the same.
Yeah. Mm, that's what the line I was looking for. Thank you.
But yeah, so what I love too, I was going to bring this up, is that Loki's magic does sort of seem like Doctor Strange's magic. They're kind of similar. Yeah. And so I think that's cool as just a unifying in-universe thing.
Right, yeah, it is cool.
Scarlet Witch is also.
Yeah, I can't wait until she actually starts.
I was going to say, Scarlet Witch's magic hasn't really
been shown
to its full potential.
Yeah, she can fuck some shit up.
What we have seen, though, did you know that she pulls her magic from the Earth?
No, I did not.
Because in all of her scenes that she fights, she, like, goes from down and throws stuff out.
Okay, yeah. Now that you're saying that. Does she still count as a mutant then? Or
no.
Is it?
She's a miracle.
Okay, so according to the canon, what it is, in the MCU, she's an enhanced being. Her and Quicksilver were made. They either had latent DNA that made them acceptable to the procedures that were done, but it was the scepter that made them have their powers, which is also why Vision is kind of super overpowered.
Okay.
But yeah, they're not technically mutants, even if they do have DNA that's different from normal humans.
Couldn't stop Rhodey out of the sky, though.
Yeah.
He shot him out of the sky.
Well, really, he just made a bunch of poor choices.
Yeah, honestly, he just was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
I thought he couldn't get distracted, Vision.
Yeah, Vision.
I did pick up the hammer.
I am worthy.
I am worthy and clumsy.
I'm good, I swear. Or he's just a fucking robot.
Yeah. That after scene, though.
I was excited initially with the Thor after credit scene.
I hear a butt.
But because I was thinking that...
It is!
I have powers?
Because I was thinking that that means that part of Thor takes place during Doctor Strange. And that's the stuff I love about the Marvel Universe, is when they have stuff that happens at the same time. Yeah.
Well, that's why me and Brandon were thinking that it was part of close-knit during Civil War. You know, you don't see where Thor is. Mm. Maybe he's talking to Strange, because Strange isn't in Civil War either.
Right.
That's why maybe they're...
No, Thor's in Australia.
That's true. That is true.
It's true.
They had an online thing, yeah.
There's a video of what it shows what Thor and Bruce Banner are doing during Civil War, and they're just in Australia.
What are they doing?
Just chilling around.
Yeah,
he got a roommate. He moved in with a guy, and
yeah, this is, he's not even lying.
He like,
I have to look this up.
Goes to this guy's office job, and it's just like, hey man, how you doing? I'm fucking Thor, isn't that awesome?
There's actually a petition to make his roommate a canon character.
He is. He's gonna be in Ragnarok.
I really hope so.
But it doesn't. The after credit scene doesn't mean that it happens directly after in any way during, right?
Okay.
Because look at the Ant-Man after credit scene, which was the Civil War scene where they're talking to Bucky.
Thought you were talking about the other one.
Yeah. When all of Civil War still takes place after Ant-Man.
Yeah. He's talking about Wasp.
Wasp is coming. But that does mean that Doctor Strange is going to show up in Ragnarok.
Yeah.
And I'm excited
about that. Doctor Strange will return.
Well, that was...
Or Ragnarok.
He says...
But they didn't say it. They just said Doctor Strange will return.
Well, no, he says in that scene, I'll help you find your father.
Yeah, that's it. I'll help. Because he just wants them gone.
Yeah.
Well, that one little scene, once again, me and Brandon were just talking about it. What does it actually tell you? Well, Thor now knows Loki's full of shit.
Yes.
Odin's gone.
But they're still together.
Yeah. He's like, okay, well, we gotta find Odin, actually.
And Loki need to find Odin. Thor.
How's it feel?
Thor doesn't have the best grammar.
Because
he's a brute.
But didn't Loki do something with Odin?
Yeah, he took
Odin's homeless guy.
Just some bum on the street.
Yeah. Oh no!
He is the set pictures are showing him as just this homeless guy, Anthony Hopkins.
Oh gosh!
And so I'm they're
really
saying
now he just really is Anthony Hopkins. Anthony Hopkins, I don't know if you're gonna listen to this, but please don't sue me.
Love
I was
you.
Just joking. I love you.
We like you so much, man.
You're really great in Silence of the Lambs.
You're great, Odin.
You are
all
great.
Seeing, all father.
Which Mads Mikkelsen, who plays Caecilius, was Hannibal Lecter in the Hannibal show.
Holy crap!
Which is hilarious because he was that guy was actually supposed to be Meliketh for Thor Dark World.
Oh, nice.
But he turned it down for that role.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good call.
That is, Caecilius is a better villain than Meliketh.
You dodged a bullet, bud.
Good on you. Two good choices.
We talked about Caecilius, but like, is he a better villain than some of the others in the MCU?
I don't think any MCU villain is better than Loki, not just because personal bias,
Winter Soldier.
But just because he's not really a villain.
He was a villain for that one awesome movie.
That one movie.
Second best movie.
But was he a villain or was he just brainwashed?
He was brainwashed. Yeah, you can't count that.
Who cares? Still does he
when he's
shit?
When you're brainwashed, you're the villain.
Did Jessica Jones get a free fucking pass when she was dude?
Yeah.
No, she's still a fucking murderer.
Exactly.
Hail Hydra.
We still talk about that all the time. In Luke Cage.
Have you ever done that, like where you just kind of walk up to a stranger?
Yes. Yes, I have.
Softly whisper in their ear, Hail Hydra.
Whenever there's one guy at work, I always do that too when I walk past him and he doesn't notice me.
Mm-hmm.
He's under my breath, go.
But yeah, I mean, like, for me, Loki will always be the best of the villains. I liked Caecilius. He was an interesting character. He wasn't in the wrong entirely because he was just essentially trying to get immortality for the entire planet.
Yeah.
Right.
He just didn't understand the consequences of his actions.
They pulled the normal Marvel villain trope of an Iron Man fights an Iron Man, a Hulk fights a Hulk, a sorcerer fights a sorcerer. And so.
I still wish Iron Man fought the Mandarin instead.
He did.
Yeah, he was the real Mandarin.
I'm the real Mandarin.
No, I'm the real Mandarin.
The thought of it all.
Really. He's just randomly going, no, I'm the Mandarin.
He had the dragon tattoo. He was the Mandarin.
He was the Mandarin. He was the
I know you guys already talked about Marvel stuff, but I was really sad at that. I really wanted a Magic versus
that would be cool.
Everybody wanted Magic.
That's what I wanted.
Yeah,
Tony Stark didn't even get Extremis. That's supposed to be a thing too.
Magic didn't exist at that point in MCU.
He blew that fire out one time.
Bah! He got really mad. He got really mad. That's a good power. You want to use it again?
That wasn't magic.
Oh.
He just had fire breath for
I got
no reason. Okay,
we're going off track. Sorry.
To finish this up, how would you rank Doctor Strange?
9 out of 10.
Not rate. Just rank it. You already
number
said
one,
number one.
He goes Strange, Winter Soldier, then Civil War.
Nice, yeah. Brandon?
I would give it a solid number 3 on my list.
Nah, fuck you.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, can I change that?
Guardians.
Take Civil War off? Guardians.
Guardians of the Galaxy. Just because it was super amazing.
You're amazing.
Age of Ultron for me, because personal bias.
Yeah.
And then number 3.
Well, I thought that'd be at the bottom of your list.
No.
It's
the only one with him. What am I supposed to do?
His hands are tied, damn it.
Fuck you, Joss Whedon, you bastard, giving me this beautiful character that you fucked.
He didn't do anything. I believe it was the guy who shot the bullets who fucked him.
That's true. It was Ultron.
Ultron succeeded.
I know you're listening, and I just want to say, Brandon's a shithead, and I agree with everything you've done, because you're an amazing man, and I love you.
He doesn't even like Quicksilver that much. He doesn't have a Funko Pop of him. He has 3 Agent 13s.
You gave me those Agent 13s.
Nobody
you
has
cocksucker.
Yeah, that shows his popularity.
Nobody in the world has 3 Agent 13s except for Brandon.
And the people selling
you
them.
Did this to me! You son of a bitch!
I would have to put... Maybe it's just my own biasm because I love Spider-Man.
Mm-hmm.
Not the actual Spider-Man movies, but Civil War gave me the Spider-Man that I always wanted.
The Spider-Man we need.
It's the
Spider-Man we deserve.
Please don't.
Oh, by the way, not to cut you off, did you see
Have
you seen pictures of Stan Lee as a kid?
Yeah.
He looks just like Tom Holland.
I have seen
it. And it looks awesome. I really love that about it. That was my favorite thing to find out. Anyway, go on.
But Civil War... probably my favorite, then Guardians, then probably Doctor Strange. Doctor Strange is really good, and like even if you're not
I've seen it twice,
even if you're not a like big superhero fan, this was just visually and artistically, it was a really good movie just for the effects and everything.
Can we talk about the 3-minute acid trip that's at the beginning of the movie when he has his mind great?
Oh, yes!
That was so good!
Oh, God! I was like, oh, this...
I felt
I thought,
sick. I was like, oh, God.
I thought Ant-Man was bad when he shrunk down.
Yeah.
That was bad, but this was not... Oh, there was no order to this whatsoever.
No. A thing I love specifically is when they basically... He travels into his own mind.
Yeah.
Because you see all these hands go over him, which is symbolic for...
No. That was nightmare fuel.
That was awesome.
You see, he holds his hand out, and then his hands aren't the fingers. And then the hand has more fingers. And then the more fingers... Oh, God.
But that's representing him wanting new hands.
Yes.
And they're just... They engulf him, and then it turns into his iris... And he falls through it.
Yeah.
It reminded me of the last time I did
it. That was awesome.
So what's your favorite then?
Okay, my list goes number 1, Civil War. Number 2, Winter Soldier. Number 3 is a 4-way tie for Doctor Strange, Guardians.
No.
Avengers and
choice.
Guardians twice.
Make a choice, Make a choice.
I would say, as of right now, Doctor Strange is my 3rd.
Okay. I'm okay with that.
It was a very good movie, and it deserves its actual place in the Marvel U.
Oh, yeah.
He's going to make a great Doctor Strange, although I thought I already casted the perfect Doctor Strange. I told you that earlier.
Was that
Reeves?
That was such a bad statement. I put it away from my mind.
Right,
the part? Yes, the part is great. Half the things he says is fucking made up anyways. That's what let him play it.
As long as Keanu Reeves does his best raspy voice.
Yes.
It has to be raspy.
I know Kung Fu.
I know Kung Fu, bro.
I know chakras.
we've been talking about this for long enough.
Too long, yeah.
So thank you for listening.
I love you. That was subpar.
With you as always,
Raimi.
Brandon.
Dana.
Not always Kyle.
Oh, by the way, guys, look up, what's your channel called?
My channel is Fenrir Sky on YouTube, Twitter. Also have a podcast called The Fang Podcast, The Forgetful and Nerdy Gamers, where acronym is cooler than us.
I love that.
It was
genius.
It was something that we thought of. And we do podcasts on Twitch every Friday at midnight. So it's actually a Twitch kind of show instead of a podcast. One of our friends, he's working nights, so he has to show up at midnight. The other one just doesn't show up till midnight.
So. Some don't show up at all.
Sure. They're dead.
Like that.
I went for a dark joke. You went for a real joke.
It's not a joke. It's my reality.
I don't believe in chakras.
Or dads.
I don't believe in dads.
I don't believe in dads or the power of my dads.